हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर न्यू लेक्चर इन ब्रिजकॉस लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीएससी पार्ट फर्स्ट, विच इज बेस्ड ऑन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट इन मैथमेटिक्स, दैट इज डिफरेंशिएशन। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर विशाखा कदम फ्रॉम प्रोफेसर संभाजीराव कदम कॉलेज देऊर। इन मैथमेटिक्स, डिफरेंशिएशन, इंटीग्रेशन, लिमिट एंड कंटिन्यूटी plays a very important role. Representation of this concept in mathematical branches are different, but meaning is same. Now we start our lecture. Here first we know about what is the derivative. The derivative is the way to show rate of change, that is the amount by which a function is changing at one given point. For more understanding, we see the one example. Suppose the function is 2x, then its derivative is 2. It is calculated by our standard derivative formula. This example can be compared with our definition. That means at given point, our function is 2x and amount changed by the point is 2. The another question is that what is the differentiation? The differentiation is the process of finding the derivative. And you remember that the reverse process is called as anti-differentiation. The derivative f dash of x or dy upon dx is also known as differential coefficient, where x is independent variable and y is dependent variable. These derivatives can be represented by different ways. Our next point is that method of finding derivatives. There are six methods of finding the derivatives as follow. First is first principle method or definition method. Second is power rule. Third is sum rule. Fourth, product rule. Fifth, question rule. And 6 is a chain rule. In BSc part first, we use product rule and chain rule. Hence, you necessary to revise the product and chain rule. Next point is that relationship between continuity and differentiability. Here, we get one result. That is, every differentiable function is continuous. It can be represented by differentiability implies continuity. But here we get one question, that is converse is true. Then answer is that converse need not be true. That means every continuous function need not be a differentiable. It is also very important result. Every student should be remember this. In next point, we know about what is the type of derivative. There are six type of derivatives. First, derivative of composite function. Second, derivative of inverse function. Third, derivative of logarithmic function. Fourth, derivative of implicit function. Fifth is derivative of hyperbolic function. Sixth is derivative of inverse hyperbolic function. First four types we will study in 12th class, and remaining two types study in this year, that is BSc part first. In this way, we get basic information about the derivatives. Now we see the various application of derivatives. The first application is that application of derivatives in various fields or sciences. The derivatives are applicable in the field of physics, biology, economics, chemistry and mathematics. Also, derivatives are more applicable in the field of physiology, sociology and geology. In the next point, we see the how derivatives are very important in our mathematical field. That is, derivatives are used for to calculate the rate of change of quantity, to find increasing and decreasing function, to find tangent and normal to the curve, also to find minimum and maximum values. derivatives are applicable in the Newton's method and linear approximations. The last, derivatives are applicable in our life to calculate for profit and loss in using graphs, to check the temperature variations, to determine the speed or distance covered, such as miles per hours, etc. Derivatives are used to derive many equations in physics. In the study of seismology, like to find the range of magnitudes of the earthquake. By solving the applications of derivatives problem, the concept for these applications will be understood better. Thank you.